Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to be talking about my personal TTC tips, trying to conceive tips, and my personal trying to conceive journey. Okay, so I have tried to record this video 3 times. This is a very sensitive subject. This is a trigger for a lot of people. And I just wanna start out with a disclaimer and say, these are just my personal tips, my personal opinions. By no means is this the only way to start your TTC journey. And I'm not a medical professional. These are just things that I found to be successful in my life during my TTC journey. Another disclaimer, my husband is in the background sawing and doing projects. If you guys don't know, we make lots of furniture on the side and that saw is constantly a going in the background. You are. All right, and of course we have Akaya with us. All right, so just kind of like a little backstory on my TTC journey is I have endometriosis. Endometriosis can or cannot affect your fertility. I personally was told at where the rate my endometriosis was at that I had about a 50-50 chance of having kids. I knew my chances were pretty good because my mom has endometriosis and she has 5 healthy, happy kids, of which I am the oldest, and I have an 8-year-old, 7 or 8-year-old little sister. Gosh, I have so many siblings, I just can't even remember. But I knew that the odds were more than likely in my favor. Rewinding back to 2014, right after my husband and I got married, knowing my odds and just knowing that we wanted a family, we wanted to be young parents, we chose to start trying right away. I just wanna say, hey, if you're on this TTC journey for your very first time, if you're stumbling on my video looking for how to start your TTC journey, make sure you have a good support system. Now, they might not always say the right things to you, especially if they haven't gone through it or aren't going through it with you, but just having somebody who can sit there and listen to you will make all the difference during this journey. And that leads me into my next thing. This is your TMI warning. This is your warning to click off this video. I will not be offended if you choose to click off of this video because this is, we're talking lady stuff. This is TMI. This is, it's sensitive information, if you will. So hopping into my journey, where I started, I remember feeling so shocked that I didn't conceive my first month. I know, in my head, I know that it takes 6 to 12 months, even when with nothing wrong with you, to conceive in general. It can take up to 6 to 12 months. I feel like we are so taught in middle school and high school, just through like sex ed and just in general, we're taught that intercourse leads to babies. Intercourse leads to babies. And if you have unprotected intercourse at all, you're going to have a baby. You're going to get pregnant. Now, this is the case for some people. One time is all it takes. And I just want you guys to know that if it doesn't happen on that first try, that's okay. It's just, gosh, I remember in my head, I'm thinking after the first time, I'm like, oh, that's it. I can't have kids, which is totally irrational. That's not the truth whatsoever. Getting into kind of the second subject of this video, my good friend Shayla, thank you for requesting this video. She brought up a really, really good point that in today's world, instant gratification is such a big thing. I feel that the instant gratification that we receive from everything. So everything from your Amazon Prime and your same day grocery delivery, I am guilty of that. Same day Target delivery, I use Shipt for Target. The instant gratification in today's society is just, it's so dominant. So here we are, we've lost some of our patience. Everybody is just so used to this instant gratification in our society that when it comes to things that take a little bit longer and take a little bit more patience, it's hard for us to mentally wrap our heads around. And a TTC journey is just that. It is a journey and it may take a little while and you might not get that instant gratification. And if you do, All the power to you, Fertile Myrtle. Okay, so now that we got the mental stuff out of the way, let's hop into the fun pot. Looking down at my phone a lot here, I was pretty thorough with my tips for you guys. Again, I'm very passionate about like this TTC journey because I remember when I was first going through it, I was the only one. I was the only one going through this and I didn't have any friends to like share my crazy TTC stuff with. I have shared a little bit more with them now that they're starting to have their own babies, but I just went crazy. And I actually had a lot of fun like looking up all this stuff. So here we go. Since I have endometriosis, and I know that that can affect fertility, I chose to start out with trying to improve my fertility and my egg quality. So I did start out by taking a lot of supplements. I was taking CoQ10. This is a really good supplement for improving your egg quality. This was recommended by my OB. And he also recommended that I get on a prenatal right away, just in case if I did conceive, I was already taking a prenatal. So those were the supplements that I was taking at the time. Now this is with my daughter, Kaya. If you're even starting to think about your TTC journey, you need to ditch the birth control because they say it could take only like a month or two for your body to get back on track. I feel like the human body is a little bit more complicated than that, but I ditched my birth control 3 months before I even started thinking about my TTC journey. Now, that was unintentional for me. My husband, 3 months before we got married, got into a very terrible accident. Getting my birth control refilled at the time was the last thing on my mind between planning my wedding, possibly having to postpone my wedding, and it was the last thing on my list. So I honestly just forgot to fill my birth control. So like in June about is when I had stopped my birth control, and we started our TTC journey in September, right after our wedding in August. So first and foremost, ditch the birth control. After I stopped taking birth control, again, we started trying to conceive right after we got married. Our anniversary is in August, so we started trying in September. The first thing that I started out doing besides the taking the supplements is I started to track my basal body temperature. Now, I just got a cheap thermometer from Walmart and I took it at the same time every single day. So you want the environment to remain the same. So every morning for me, I knew I always, you know, the first thing as soon as I woke up in the morning, I would take my basal body temperature. And again, I just got a little thermometer from like Walmart or Target and I took it inside vaginally. So that was the first thing that I did. And to track all of this information, my favorite app was Ovia. Inside Ovia, this will help keep everything in one place for you. I was able to keep track of my basal body temperature inside of this app, along with when I got my period, along with when I had my baby dancing days, along with any other symptoms I was feeling. It kept it all in one place for me, let me know what my fertility score was for the day, and so I would use all of this information in combination with ovulation tests to tell me when my best days were to conceive. So with this app and with the help of like my ovulation tests, I feel like the first couple months of not conceiving right away was because I was learning my body and I was learning how the system works, if you will. But I really got to know my body with the Ovia app. Now that's just my personal favorite app. There's lots of fertility tracking apps out there right now. I'm sure there's so much more than even when I started trying to conceive in 2014. It's been what, 5 years now almost? Is that right? Oh my gosh. It's been like 4.5 years because we started like late 2014, but that's crazy. Okay, so ovulation, if you do not know, in a normal 28 to 32 day menstrual cycle will start right around days 10 to 19, which is about 12 to 16 days before your next period. Now, again, that's just if you have a normal 28 to 32 day cycle. A better way to track it is that 10 to 16 days before you're due to get your next period. So if you do have a longer cycle, you're usually safer with doing the 10 to 16 days. I personally have a very short cycle. I do not even have a 28 day cycle. I had about a 21 to 25 day cycle. So it took us, I can't remember, it was 5 or 6 cycles to conceive my daughter the first time. Again, that's because I have very short cycles and it took some time learning exactly when my body ovulates. Yeah, so this again, this is very general, the 28 to 32 day range and the 10 to 16 day range. And there are many other factors and diseases that can impact when you ovulate. Again, this is just what worked for me and this is just a general statement, but just given out the general information on ovulation. There is a generalized fertile window that is best for you to conceive. Now this is a 5 to 7 day window. They tell you typically about 6 days during your cycle when your chances are best to conceive. Now this is just a guesstimate and your days could be longer. It could be 1 day, 2 days. This again is just a very generalized statement. So during this 5 to 7 day period, your chances of conception are at its highest. You can conceive technically at any point during your cycle. This is just when it's at its highest. I'm gonna leave an article down below just getting more into depth on ovulation. If this is truly your first video, your first time trying to conceive, I highly recommend just like searching up on your body, getting to know your body, getting to know when the ovulation occurs. And because honestly, when I first started, I wasn't familiar with any of this and it wasn't something that was on my mind ever before. So again, the first couple months, the first couple cycles really just was me getting the hang of my body and learning the whole ovulation thing. Signs of ovulation. Now this is like besides using an ovulation test, these are just like physical signs that you are ovulating. With tracking your basal body temperature, I feel like this was probably the most key thing for me. Your basal body temperature is going to slightly dip right before you ovulate. And then it's going to spike right after you ovulate. Now that spike is going to be about like a 0.4 to 1 degree difference. Your basal body temperature should be reading anywhere between 97.2 and 97.6 on a daily basis. So as soon as you see it deviate, and you'll kind of get to know too, if you've been tracking for a month or two, you'll know when your dip is and you'll know when your spike is. So, and if you connect the dots of that along with your ovulation tests, it really helps to cue in that exact best day to conceive. Again, you can conceive at any point in your cycle. It's just that is your key day. It's your O day, your ovulation day. Your cervical mucus when you're ovulating should, this is TMI, your cervical mucus should resemble the consistency of egg whites or just be very wet and slippery. I am so sorry, you guys, but honest to goodness, that is like one of the best tips that I personally found on my TTC journey and kind of getting to know my body, that those consistencies are clues as to when you're ovulating. Other symptoms can include like mild pelvic discomfort, so it might kind of feel like you're getting your period. Not even that much, just a little bit of cramping down there. Your breasts might be a little bit sore, your libido might change, you might be really wanting your man to come home, if you know what I mean. There is a possibility too that you'll have like light spotting during this time when you're ovulating. Now, I've never had that happen to me before, and I feel like that can be very confusing for some because light spotting is also in relation to implantation bleeding. So I don't know, I feel like there's so many things that you can get confused on, but they do say that light spotting is a sign that you could be ovulating. Another product that I used, in addition to like keeping track of all of my physical signs on the Ovia app, another product I used was the Preseed. Now, like back when I was trying, again, this was all like unheard of to me. It was all unheard of to my friends and my family. It's just, these were not things that were talked about. So I was really excited when I found this Preseed lubricant. I'm sure they have lots of different versions of it on the market now. This was back in 2014. So Preseed is what we use, and it is a fertile, it's like a fertility friendly lube. And it's supposed to mimic the pH and the consistency of your cervical mucus at its most fertile time. And it's supposed to help the spermies get to where they need to go. I definitely recommend pre-seed. We used it religiously when we were trying to conceive. So I don't know if it made a difference, but I can definitely tell you that it probably didn't hurt. It just made our chances that much better. So that is a product that I recommend you use, or at least look into if you are trying to conceive. My favorite ovulation test to use are the clear blue ones, just because they're really simple for me to read. It was a smiley face or a sad face. I can't remember if there was like a double smiley face on like the high, like your ultimate ovulation, or if there was like a slightly smile, like a big smile. I can't remember, but those are the tests that I used. That's the brand that I used, and I did thoroughly enjoy it. Again, I combined all of my physical signs along with my ovulation test. And also those cheap dipsticks on Amazon. Those were another really good ovulation test that I used, which is gonna bring me on to my next topic, and that is what my favorite pregnancy test was to use. I had the most success with First Response, Early Response, or Early, it's FRER is what it's abbreviated to on these, on like the baby boards. Baby Center, I love Baby Center for all of their TTC tips as well, and all of their like mommy and TTC boards. I highly recommend that you get on there. Use that community as your support system. That's what I did. I was definitely on there a few times, posting like my pictures of my pregnancy test, seeing if there's a slight line, because they call them tweakers, like photo tweakers. They would go on there and they would like tweak your photo for you to see if there was like any sign of a faint line. Like it's pretty crazy, guys, but this is what happens when you're trying to conceive. Anyway, so my favorite tests were the pink dip dye test, which you can get off of Amazon, and then those would be your First Response pregnancy tests. And I received my first, my BFP, my big fat positive, I received my first positive at 10 days past ovulation with Kaya, which, by the way, the blue was not showing anything at that time, and it wasn't until 11 days past ovulation that there was a hint of a positive with the blue, even though the clear blue electronic at the time, that came up right away. So I don't know what it is with that blue dye. So those are my favorite pregnancy tests and my favorite ovulation tests to use. Now I'm gonna kind of start rolling into my second experience with trying to conceive, and it is a totally different experience than compared to with my daughter Kaya. So this time around, this baby boy who's still cooking, which you need to get out, their son, I'm very overdue. Eviction notice has been issued for him. But my journey this time, and I wasn't even going to share this just because I didn't want to offend anybody, but I feel like it's good information to put out there, and I feel that maybe it could help somebody else out there to see how I handled my TTC journey the first time compared to how I handled it this time. My husband and I, so we just built a house last year, and we told ourselves we were going to wait 1 year until we started to try and conceive our second child. Now, the reason why we were doing this is because we had a planned trip to Mexico in February of 2018, which was just a few short months after we built our house. And for those of you who do not know, Mexico is a Zika zone. So the Zika virus, I'll leave a link down below for you guys if you're not familiar with it, but the Zika virus is something that can affect an unborn child and can affect the mother and the father. And there are known birth defects with this disease. It is spread around by mosquitoes, similar to like malaria. And we were waiting that 6 month, it's like a 6 month period that you have to wait to be out of the danger zone, if you will, of being affected by Zika. So long story short, we were not planning on trying until that fall, so August, September, so that we were clear out of that 6 month Zika danger zone. Now let's back it up again. So going back to when we first moved into our house, my husband and I had started our keto journey or low carb, high fat journey. This is something that we are very passionate about. My husband and I love nutrition. We love to see how our bodies react to certain foods. It's just something that we're very passionate about. We've dabbled in veganism and vegetarianism. We've done keto, and it's fun to see how your brain and your energy and your body can change just with a simple change in your diet. So anyways, we've gotten on this keto kick, and I am still very much so a keto fan, and I lost a lot of weight for my trip to Mexico. I was feeling good. I feel like I was looking pretty good. I lost like a lot of the extra weight that I had on me from having Kaya. I felt good, and my energy was amazing. Now when I say high fat, it was healthy fat. So I was having a lot of avocado, a lot of nuts, just really good healthy fats. So just kind of like a little backstory on our keto journey. So during this time too, I had also learned that a healthy high fat, low carb diet can improve your egg quality and your fertility. Now I remember reading this and I didn't think much of it at the time because we weren't trying to conceive. I just wanted to look dang good for Mexico. So it wasn't something that I necessarily was thinking of at the time. I just was doing it to look good and to feel good, right? Time's passed, we've gotten to Mexico, we're continuing to do keto, I'm continuing to work out and have a healthy lifestyle. I was working out 5 to 6 times a week. I was running like three miles a day on my elliptical or my treadmill. I was just really, I was in good shape. I was feeling pretty good. I was shedding that weight. 3 months after we got back from Mexico, almost exactly, it was Memorial Day weekend, and I got really sick. We were on a trip to South Dakota in the Badlands, and I got really sick, and I didn't even think anything of it. I didn't think anything of it because I was on birth control. I just thought I ate something bad. And what's really funny is, and I'm putting this in here mostly for myself, but what's really funny is I remember driving home, and it was like a 6-8 hour drive back home on Memorial Day, and Mike and I are starting to plan like when we're gonna like start trying to conceive. We were getting a little antsy, I will admit, but we were trying to wait out that 6 month danger zone from like going to Mexico and possibly being exposed to Zika. But I was just saying, you know, oh, you know, whatever. Wouldn't it be so funny if God's laughing right now and I'm pregnant right now? Wouldn't that be so funny? And we just kind of laughed it off because there was no way I could be pregnant, right? In our minds, for some reason, there was no way. So the next day, my first day back at work after Memorial Day weekend, I had a dentist appointment, and I started to do the math and add up in my head, and I was due for my period like the day before or the day before that. And I just wanted to be safe, and I didn't want to get too excited. I wanted to be safe, so I went and purchased my first response, early response or early detecting test, the pink dye test, over at Walgreens, and I took the test in the dentist's bathroom right beforehand because they take x-rays at the doctor, and if I was pregnant, I didn't want them to take x-rays, right? And I really didn't expect it to be positive, but you guys, it was positive. I was like, it was like blatantly, obviously positive. And I was like blown away. I was shocked. Just one of the best feelings, you guys, absolutely one of the best feelings. I just kept thinking, how is this possible? I was on birth control. I took it on time every single day. We only baby danced once this month because I was sick with a UTI after that. And I didn't understand how it happened. I was so excited that it was happening, but I was blown away. I didn't understand how it was happening. After doing a lot of research, I found so many stories that were similar to mine where, you know, their TTC journey the first time was not difficult, but took longer. And then as soon as they started keto, they turned into these like amazing fertile myrtles. Keto can be really good for the males and the females. So the fact that both my husband and I were doing it, I feel like just turned us into these like fertile bombs. And I really truly do believe that being so healthy and working out every single day and being keto with lots of healthy fats had a lot to do with the fact that I just, boom, got pregnant and didn't even have to think about it. Now, I was a little bit scared, obviously, because we were still in that Zika danger zone. We were only like 3 months out from returning from Mexico, so I was really nervous, but that's another side story. But everything turned out fine. Baby's fine, I'm fine. Baby's fine, I'm fine. There's no birth defects. And honest to goodness, it was only a few months sooner than we were planning on trying to conceive, so it was a very welcomed surprise. Yeah. So my TTC journey, my second time around, was so much different compared to my first time around, and I wouldn't have had it any other way. Again, I am not a medical professional. I can't tell you for sure if that's the reason why I conceived so quickly my second time was because of the keto, but I do think it is, because I just found so many similar stories out there. I urge you to go out there, read on the baby boards and the TTC boards in regards to keto, not just a low carb diet, but a low carb high fat diet with really healthy fats. I feel like those healthy fats just amped me up and amped my husband up, and we were just a really good combo, if you know what I mean. So I don't know, I've wanted to share this story because my two TTC journeys were so different, but I've just been scared because it is a sensitive topic, it's a trigger topic. So I just remember, guys, this is just my personal story, these are my personal opinions, and it's just something I'm very passionate about. I love being a mom. I've loved this journey that I've been on. This is just such a sensitive journey, trying to conceive a child and bringing a child into the world is a very sensitive topic, and that is why I've been hesitant on sharing these stories. I hope that my stories help you guys or help somebody out there. Again, please remember that this is just what I've been through, and it may not work for you. It may not work for you, but that's okay. Going back to my first tip, just make sure you guys have a good support system. Your mental health is the most important thing. You are the most important thing. So when you're going through a journey like this, an important and exciting, scary journey like this, just make sure that you have the right support in your life, or at least be that supporter for yourself. All right, there's my TTC story, and there's my TTC tips for you guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did like this video on my channel, I know it's a long one, but it was an important one. Please give it a big thumbs up so that I know you like this kind of content on my channel. Leave a comment down below. Again, share your stories with me. I wanna hear what were your trying to conceive tips. What were your stories? I wanna hear them. Be sure you're subscribed to my channel, because again, we got an eviction notice for this 41 week overdue baby in my tummy. And I will be sharing the birth vlog with you guys as soon as I possibly can. I have my I'm in labor video ready to go, and as soon as I am in labor or I'm going in for my induction, I will make sure that that is live for you guys. Make sure you're following me over my Instagram so that you don't miss out on the second I go into labor, for I'll be sharing a lot on my Instagram stories when I go into labor, so make sure you're following me over there as well. Again, thank you for tuning in today, you guys, and I will see you sometime in the very near future, hopefully Sunday or Tuesday. Okay, bye guys. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world.